In this session, we are going to discuss about perpendicular lines and perpendicular bisector. To understand what are perpendicular lines, let us relate this with the pair of intersecting lines what we have discussed in our previous sessions. We know that when the two lines cross each other or meet each other at a point, angles are formed and this pair of lines are perpendicular lines, correct? So through this point, this is your point of intersection. You can see angles are formed, correct? So same thing now, let us relate this with the perpendicular lines. In perpendicular lines also, you have certain part of the definition of intersecting lines. That is, the two lines will meet each other or cross each other at a point. And can you see through this point angles are formed? Here also angles will be formed. But the pair of angles formed are at right angle. Let us understand. We say for perpendicular line that when the two lines, take it for example, this is line segment AB. And through this, if I drop a line, perpendicular line at a point, and you will see here the angle formed is right angle. This is how perpendicular lines are different from intersecting lines. Because in intersecting lines also, the two lines are going to intersect each other. But not necessary that through this point, can you see the angles? They will not be always at right angle. But for it to be perpendicular line, the two lines will always intersect at right angle. Got it? So perpendicular line can be represented by the symbol C inverted T. You can represent this. This is the symbol for perpendicular. So here line segment AB, and you can see a drop down line which is crossing line segment AB at a point and it forms 90 degree. So CD is perpendicular on line segment AB. So you can represent this also by symbolic representation. Correct? Now through intersecting lines, we understood what are perpendicular lines. Now through perpendicular line, we will move to perpendicular bisector. See children, for perpendicular lines, we understood that the lines will cross each other at right angle. This part is same for perpendicular bisector also. But there is a slight difference between perpendicular lines and perpendicular bisector. Here the line, see, this perpendicular bisector is on this line, say for example AB, correct? But suppose the length of the line segment AB is 12 centimeters. Now, this is also, take for example, is 12 centimeters. So for perpendicular line, it can drop down through any point on the line segment. But for it to be perpendicular bisector, it will always bisect, it will always intersect through the center point of the line segment, the middle point of the line segment. So AB is a line segment whose measurement is 12 centimeters. So the midpoint of line segment AB will be, correct, here at C. So the midpoint here, you can see, it will divide the line into two equal half. This point C is the midpoint. Why? Because this is the center point. So through C, if you measure AC, you will see that this is half of the line segment. And through C, again, if you measure C and B, you will see it is also half of the line. That is, it is dividing. This point C is dividing the line segment into equal halves. So through this point only, a perpendicular bisector, if you drop it down at right angle, then it is called as perpendicular bisector. Have you understood the basic difference between perpendicular lines and perpendicular bisector? That in perpendicular lines, the lines will intersect each other at right angle. Correct? Not necessary, it will fall on, always on the center point. This line, perpendicular line, is not falling on the center point of line segment AB. This is also AB. But for it to be perpendicular bisector, the line will fall, will be dropped down from the middle point of the foot of this line, base of this line. The perpendicular bisector will be dropped through the center point of the baseline at right angle. Here also at right angle, but it can be at any point, not always on midpoint, correct? But this will always be intersected through the midpoint of the line segment. So it will do two things. First is it will intersect at a right angle, plus it will divide the line into two equal halves. So this is the basic difference between three types of lines which are quite similar to each other. First is intersecting pair of lines. So this is also intersecting pair of lines, correct? But intersecting lines will not always intersect at right angle. Take for example, see here, the pair of angles so formed. Can you see? This pair is acute angle and here you have obtuse angle. That means it will cross at a point. Angles will be formed, but not always at right angle. In these two, the angles will always be formed at right angle. But here, at any point on the line segment, you can have the perpendicular, but for perpendicular bisector, it will always be through the center point of the foot of the line segment. Correct?